Hi there, it's Ben Housel here, and in this quick tutorial I'm going to be covering how to create this flicker text effect. Now this tutorial is inspired by a YouTuber called Lasura, who makes some great, very succinct Final Cut Pro tutorials. You should definitely check them out. I've left a link below in the description. And essentially what we're going to do is take Lasura's tutorial and add in some extra effects in there to add some more texture into the project, as well as showing how you can use blend modes and the colorize effect on your video as well. So this is what we're going to end up with, or something similar. And we're going to start off with this original video here, which I've already stabilized. So if we look up to the inspector on the top right, and if you don't see the inspector, just come to Window, Show in Workspace and Inspector, and you'll see the inspector up there. And essentially I've checked the smooth cam stabilization just to smooth this handheld footage a little bit before we add the text over the top of it. The next thing we need to do is come up to the top left, where we're going to grab the type tool, and then we're looking for the basic title. So we're going to scroll down here and find our basic title. If you have a long list of titles and you don't want to look for it there, then you can also use the search field. Just type in basic and it will show up there pretty quickly. And we'll drag this down to the timeline. So essentially what we're going to do here first of all is add the text and some of the blend effects to the background so that we can have a little bit of transparency in our text. So I'm going to grab the blade tool first of all. The shortcut for the blade is B. And we're going to use this a little bit in this tutorial for a couple of things. And I'm going to then jump back to the select tool, just so I can delete some of the extra part of this title that I don't need. And then we'll highlight our type, come up to the inspector again, and we're looking for the show the text inspector button up here, and we'll type in our text. So just gonna type in the word Panama, which is where this reef break is. And then for this text, we're gonna add a 2D style to it. So we're gonna use the grunge effect here. So once I've added this, I'm gonna scroll down here so I can see my basic text options. And all I wanna do is kind of ramp this up in size almost as big as I can so it fills the screen. And you can see we've got other options in here which we don't really need to change for the moment. But what we will change under the video options, so if we come up to the top of our inspector here, looking for the little film strip, we're gonna change the blend mode of this to darken. We're gonna change the blend mode of this to lighten, which is gonna let, you can see here, the sky and the rocks and stuff show through that type. So wherever we move it, we're going to have a little bit of that background showing, which is going to be nice. It's going to let the waves kind of show through a little bit. So let's just center this here. And one thing we've done already on the video layer below is we've dropped the opacity, or the transparency of that layer, just so that video pops out a little bit more. So this is what we have for the moment. And what we're going to do is we're going to slice up the beginning of this clip. So we're going to come to our timeline and zoom right in. So to zoom in, I normally use Command and Plus just to zoom right in until we can see the individual frames. You can see as I'm moving along my timeline there, here I can see those individual frames. And now we're going to jump back to the blade tool. So we'll tap the B key, or grab the blade tool from our list of tools here. And then we're going to slice this into different sections. And as we move through there, we'll see we can slice this up really easily, just coming along frame by frame. So once we've sliced this into five or six sections, we're going to jump back to the select tool. And now, quite simply here, what we can do to make the flicker effect is we can highlight, holding down the command key, each of these individual elements, and then just tap the V key. And what that will do is mean we'll end up with an effect like this, where the text flickers on, which is quite nice, but I want to look at how we can modify that a little bit. So one thing we can do, and tapping the V key is just enabling or disabling the clips there. So if we re-enable those, now with these three clips selected, we can actually modify those three clips at the same time. So if I come up to my video options, I can change the opacity of those three clips. We'll just put the playhead over the top of one of them. So we can lower the opacity, so we can have that flickering, but not becoming completely invisible. So you can see it still flickers, but we're getting a slightly different effect. And then now if we move through each of these frames one at a time, I'm just gonna deselect them by clicking in the gray area on the timeline. If we come up to our transform properties, we can come through each of these clips and then nudge the position of alternating words. So you can see here now as I do this, when we play this back through, and I'm kind of nudging them up to the left and down to the right, and then for the final one, before we drop into position, We'll go right across to the right hand side and then up to the top right. And so what you'll see here now is that we get a little bit more movement in that flicker effect, which looks pretty cool. So the other thing we can do here as well to accentuate this a bit more is if we highlight these clips one at a time, we can also scale them. And if you scale them bigger, it will produce a cool effect. What we can also do, we can experiment with these in different ways for each one, is we can squish them or stretch them out. So we're going to get a bit of a distorted effect as we move through those different bits of text. And I'll just nudge these into a different position so we get some nice movement in there. So it's really going to look like the text is flying around the screen and then pulling back into position as we move through there. So if we play this through here, once it's rendered, you'll see we get this nice flickering that kind of jumps around the screen a little bit, is revealing the background, and we can modify and play with that as we move through. Now, if we want to finish this up, one thing we can do as well is if we highlight this type and we can copy it, we'll come to the end of that type menu and then we can paste it on, and it means we get a flicker on and a flicker off. We'll just let that render so it plays through nicely. So you can see we have the flickering of those different effects, and we also have the flickering out of that effect as well. Come to the background. The one last thing we can do is just add the colorize effect to that layer. Now, if we add colorize, we'll have more intensity if we bring the opacity back up. So I'm going to bring my opacity back up, and then I'm going to map to an orange here for the blacks, and then let's go for a little magenta or purple here. And then if we increase the intensity, you can see we're going to change that quite dramatically. So we'll actually leave it up here and just modify these colors a little bit. Things can get quite psychedelic quite quickly here, which we don't quite want, but we'll go for a blue or magenta that's a little bit closer to the color we picked before, and push the intensity up a little bit more to almost 100%. So now if we come back to our type here, you can see we're going to dance that type across this colorized video, which is going to look quite good. So I'm just going to hold down shift and tap Z so I can view my entire timeline. So you can see a couple of different colorized options here in the first option I chose, and my scale options there were a little less dramatic in my first version. So you can play around with that, have some fun and see what will work. So thanks for checking out this video, and take a look in the links below for the inspiration for this video as well, and I look forward to seeing you on the next tutorial.